I came to MUM, my goal was to go and get an MFA in musical theater. And so that's still a part of my heart and what I want to do, performing, because I feel like the God in me comes out when I'm on the stage in front of people. Former, I was feeling like there is something else there. I felt like there was something I needed to have before I went into that particular environment. Like, I really enjoyed the performance part of it, and even creating too. But the stress that came along with it, and I don't know, just feeling like there was some deeper connection that I could possibly have, that I could provide for an audience, or to share that type of connection with the audience. I didn't quite feel like those particular qualities were nourished in me yet, or there was a potential, but you know, they needed to be watered somehow. And you know, it's just like that deeper self that's in you, and it's like, it's that voice that like gives light to like who you are, and like, and how you connect with other people, and how you can like help bring light to their lives as well. And so that started to be watered, you know. And then, you know, and once your seeds start to water, you know, a tree naturally wants to keep growing. So that's what I wanted. I wanted to keep growing. So I did everything possible that, you know, that the school had to offer that allowed that growth to come about. I just feel like it's these building blocks to like, for me to like bring those two worlds together. And then right now I'm just working on like learning more about silence, learning more about knowledge and speaking knowledge, and like sharing that with others, and then being able to to share that gift of transcending with other people. I finished the master's in Vedic science, and after that I became a TM teacher. And I decided to go and work in the San Francisco school district on the school projects out there. We teach TM in the public school district. And right now we have 4 schools in San Francisco, but there are 15 schools on the waiting list. And we've had even more schools asking if they can have quiet time program in their school. I teach in a high school. The kids are from age 15 to 18. Think that the kids at first respond to it, they can be a little bit aloof at first, and then you know, as you kind of tell them like what it's about, what TM does, and like it's simple, it's easy, it's natural, you know, but they kind of start to listen more when you kind of bring it to their life and relate it to who they are, you know, or who they see themselves as on the earth right now. For me, they kind of feel like my brothers and sisters, because I mean, I'm not too much older than them, and so I kind of feel like they really listen when I speak to them, and it feels good because you kind of have that quality of like, I'm actually really giving back to my community, and I can see that happening on a daily basis, that I'm making an impact in these kids' lives.